So St. Patrick's Day is just around the corner, and I don't know about you, but I have to wear a specific uniform to work, so I don't want nobody pinching me. So I came up with this green cut crease, green lip, kind of monochromatic, but whatever, makeup look, so that nobody can sneak up behind me and pinch me. And I do use the Morphe and Kathleen Lights palette in this look, because this green right here is to die for. And I also made a custom lipstick with the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip palette. So if you want to see how I achieve this look, keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and leave some comments below, and don't forget to follow my other social media. Alright, see you soon, guys. Okay, so I already primed my eye, and I went ahead and set it with the lightest matte shade here, but the next thing I'm going to do is just take a crease brush. This is by Royal Elaine Nicole. Any crease brush will do. And first I'm going to dip it into this color right here and work it in that transition crease area, just to get a little bit of color there. And then I'm going to dip it in that same color and in this like more muted pukey brown here, a little bit of both of those, tap off the extra and work that as my transition. After that, what I do is I take, this is also by Royal Elaine Nicole, it's the BX95, if that matters. I'm gonna take this, like, it's like a grayish brown color, and kind of map out where I want that crease to be. So I just work some of that in, because that's where I want my crease to be. But because we're kind of trying to do a cut crease, after I use that color, I'm going to take a, where'd you go, actual small angled liner brush and dip it into this matte black down here. And the very bottom of where I mapped that grayish color, I'm going to draw a thin line, and that's going to be the cut. And I tried doing cut creases like the way other people do, where they first map where they want the cut to be and then blend upwards. And I haven't quite mastered that. So that's why I first use a muted shade above where I want the crease to be. That way it looks like it's been blended up. And I have that cut there. And I'm gonna go back into that grayish muted color and above it. And like I said, it's going to look like it's been blended. You need a blending brush for this. Look like it actually has been blended upwards. And really what you basically did is did the two steps backwards. And I don't know, that just works easier for me. Or I noticed that it did work when I tried it on this. So now to cut that crease, I used an e.l.f. smudge pot, which I thought was gonna be similar to a matte paint pot, but this is in Back to Basics, and I don't know if you can see it, but it has a shimmer to it, but that's okay because we're just gonna use this as the base color for that green underneath. But you put this underneath that black line to cut the crease. And I don't recommend tugging at your eyelid because apparently that causes wrinkles, but I do it sometimes. You could also use concealer here, but I used concealer yesterday when I was trying this and I didn't like the way it turned out. So I'm just gonna try this paint pot or e.l.f. smudge pot today. And really, I think what happened yesterday was I accidentally got too much concealer, because you guys know the Tarte Shape Tape, a little bit goes a long way. Well, I got bored in a little bit. And the start of the show is going to be this beautiful green color. And I just pack it on over top of that smudge pot. Staying underneath of that black line. And this, because it's a shimmery shadow, it does have some fallout. So that's one of the reasons why when I'm trying new looks or dealing with shimmery stuff, I always do my eye makeup first, because then you can clean up any of the fallout when you apply your foundation. And once you apply the green, just get back into that black color and redefine your cut so that that black color stands out. And I don't know if it's the brush I'm using or if it's the actual shadow, but I like about this shadow is that it's not super, super pigmented, so that you can actually work with it and not draw a really dark, harsh line. Get back into that blending brush, go into that muted gray color, and blend. Some more, and then we're going to use that first blending brush and dip into these two colors some more and blend out the very top. And then you just take some liquid eyeliner. This is NYC eyeliner, which they discontinued, which I'm kind of bummed about because this is my first time using it, or rather my second time using it. and I kind of like it. And I just made that way too big. I'm going to put on some mascara, pop on some lashes, and I will be right back. Okay, so I went ahead and basically applied my foundation, concealer, and set everything. I figure most of us know how to do that already. If you want to see a foundation routine from me, let me know down in the comments below and I will make that happen. But for now, we're just going to finish up the eyes and add some color back to the face, and we will be done. Taking this Morphe brush, it's just a shader brush, I'm going to dip into this color right here and smudge that all underneath the lower lash line. I'm also going to take some of this, that brighter color and add a little bit of that as well. Bringing it down some. And then I'm going to get a eyeliner brush and this deep olive shimmering green. I'm going to the outer two-thirds of each of the lower lash line, I'm going to press that in to add some depth to the bottom. And you know, you gotta assume that mouth open position while you do this. Go back into these two colors and kinda blend that out. I'm leaving the inner corner, the inner third of my eye blank, because I'm going to put a highlight color there, obviously, which I need to find a brush for that. I'm going to, this is from my Urban Decay palette, but this really shimmery light color, I'm going to try that. And that brush did not work. This is a crown brush. It's a detail pencil brush. And hopefully the purple that is on it doesn't translate, because I forgot to clean the brush. And I am going to take that Urban Decay brush and use that color to highlight right here under brow bone. Then we make the ugly face and apply mascara to the lower lashes. Oh, we're gonna act like I did not just do that.
Are you in the bathroom?
Nope. Yep, we're gonna act like I did not just do that because that's not how I do my face. Next. Time to add color to the skin, so I'm going to bronze with, this is from Model Company, and it is a, ooh, it's shimmer. I don't know what this, hold please. Okay, let's try the e.l.f. bronzer palette. I'm not in the mood for shimmery bronzer. We'll go with this light, this shade here, and I'm gonna mix it in with a little bit of these two right here. My goal today is not really to contour, but just really add some warmth back to the face. The forehead. A little more. Here. And under the neck. Bringing it down. Okay. Highlights. Wet n Wild Mega Glow Illuminating Palette. And I'm going to hopefully use this brush. Dip into, I'm just gonna go all over. Above brows, right, tapping the middle of the forehead, nope, I don't like to do my cupid like that. Will I use a brush? Yes, I'll use this lighter shades on the cupid's bow. Center of the nose and right here down the bridge. And did not like how that worked, so I'm gonna use my finger instead. Big fluffy brush. Nope. I forgot blush. Tarte Captivating. You always use blush after bronzer and highlight to blend the two together. And I forgot how pigmented that was. Okay, now, before I apply lower mascara, I like to set my face. And that just keeps the lower mask, the mascara from bleeding onto the face. Before we do mascara, lower lashes, I'm going to do lips so that my face can dry a little more. And I'm going to, in theory, play with this Anastasia Beverly Hills kit because I want a, kind of want a green lip. Is that weird? No, it's not weird. Let's be real. So, using primary colors, yellow, and blue should make green, right? Add a little bit of white to, in theory, lighten that up some. Where it looks like a nice, okay, apparently it's going to look like a nice baby. Oh, it's changing color. There we go, there we go. No idea how this is going to look on the lips, but we're going to see. And I'm going to take this shade right here, which I think is number 8, is kind of brownish. I'm going to try to line my lips with that. In hindsight, that is so not brown, but we'll see. Let's apply some mascara now. All right, so this is the finished look. I did not fully intend on making it monochromatic with the green lid and the green lips, but this is for St. Patrick's Day, so why not? I don't know. I don't know what you guys think, but I kind of like it.